this is going to pass because it's right for America.
As promised, we are joined now by Governor Howard Dean, former chairman of the Democratic National Committee and a 2004 candidate for the Democratic presidential nomination. Thank you for your time tonight, Governor.
Thanks for having me on.
Governor Dean, you have been on this cause of health care reform for decades. There has been no more energetic cheerleader for this legislative crusade this time around than you. You have reached the point now where the Senate bill, which is well on its way to becoming the Lieberman bill, is something you can no longer support and you want to kill it. Tell us why.
Well, I'm not going to give up on health care reform. I'm still hopeful that something will happen in the House, but it's not very likely because the conference committee could be vetoed by Joe and the other pro-insurance company Democrats when it comes back as well. So real reform in the House is a lot less likely given what's happened in the Senate. This is not real reform. It's not health care reform. There are no choices. What the decision has been made without really thinking about it, it's been made because people are exhausted and they want to pass a bill so desperately they're not thinking about what they're doing here. It's been made to commit the United States to health care reform through the private sector. Now, I don't think that decision should be made lightly. In the previous bills, the Medicare buy-in, the public option, had the choice of mixtures, of giving Americans the opportunity to make their own choices. Those choices have been taken away by the pro-insurance folks in the Senate. I think that's a mistake. Are there some good things in this bill? Yes. This is basically the Mitt Romney bill in Massachusetts, except it doesn't insure as high a percentage of people. The exchanges work well, although there's no cost control of any substance. You're going to be forced to buy health insurance from a company that's going to take, on average, 27% of your money so they can pay CEOs $20 million a year and so they can have return on equity in their shareholders. And there's no choice about that. If you don't buy that insurance, you're going to get a fine. So this is a bill that was fundamentally written by staffers who were friendly to the insurance industry, held up so that it was friendly to the insurance industry by senators who take a lot of money from the insurance industry. And it is not health care reform. And I think it's too bad. It should come to this.
And, Governor, the compromising isn't over. There are days left in this process, at least, where we can expect even more compromises. What would be your advice to a senator, a Democratic senator on the floor of the Senate, on passage of this bill? The choice is to vote yes or no.
No. Absolutely not. You can't vote for a bill like this in good conscience. It costs too much money. It isn't health care reform. It's not even insurance reform. Take, for example, this. There's a lot of talk about people who have pre-existing conditions can get health insurance. Well, not exactly. The fine print in the Senate says, but the health care industry gets to charge you three times as much if you're older than if you're younger. And they get to write the rules. That's in the Senate bill. This bill is no longer reform.
Governor, after that no vote, strategically, where would you say the Democrats should go?
Well, if it were me, as I don't think this will happen, if it were me, I'd kill the bill all entirely and have the House start in reconciliation, which is what they should have done in the first place. To be held up by four senators, a minority of 40 who are totally uncooperative, which is the Republicans, and then four senators who are beholden to the insurance industry, I think is wrong. But that's what's happened. So the other thing you could do is pass the good stuff, pass the exchanges, pass the money for the prevention and wellness, pass the community health care center money in a small bill. Don't run our children into debt and come back and do this 2 years later. I disagree with the administration when they say a president won't take this on for another 20 years. We're in crisis here. This bill, I think, is more likely to make the crisis worse than it is better because it's so expensive. So we can come back with the new Congress, which unfortunately, as a result of all this, will have fewer Democrats, but it'll still have Democratic majorities. We could come back with a new Congress, and we could pass a bill, which we had on the Senate floor last week, that would insure people faster, even though it's delayed by a year and a half, than the bill that's going to be passed in the Senate.
And, Governor, as to Senator Lieberman, you were chairman of the Democratic Party. You recruited candidates all over the country. Did you say to them, when you get into that Congress and on the Democratic side, you've got to be with us on every single vote? I mean, how do you police Democratic loyalty once the election is over?
I'm not going to get into that. Joe loves the attention. And just to make Joe the issue, I think, is a mistake. The issue is, are we going to have real health care reform or are we not? And evidently, we're not. But we still got to fight for it. And this isn't the end of the fight. This is a terrible disappointment. It's a disappointment to the American people. It's a disappointment to all of us who've worked so hard for real reform. It's a disappointment, frankly, for people who thought they ought to have choices that the Senate shouldn't make for them and force them into buying insurance where 27% of the money comes off the top. But that's, we are where we are, and we're going to keep fighting. We are not going to stop this fight.
Governor Howard Dean, I know how difficult this decision has been for you today to come out against this bill. Thank you very much for joining us tonight.
Thank you.